We have number question number 2. And this is a piecewise function. So this side is what we have to consider first, the if part. This is our domain. And so then we decide which piece of the function we're to use. And each of these pieces, you want to think of them as sort of like y equals, so this would just be y equals 1 if x is equal to negative 2, and this is y equals 1 fourth x plus 1. So we take our first one, y, our g of negative 4. We compare the domain. If x is negative 4, it's not equal to 2, so we're going to use this one here. So g of negative 4, we take this function here, 1 fourth x plus 1, and we plug in negative 4 right here for the x. So we could think of this as negative 4 divided by 4, which is going to give us negative 1 plus 1, which gives us 0. So this answer here is 0. Next we do x is negative 2, so g of negative 2. Well, if x is negative 2, then it is equal to negative 2, so we're going to use the second one here, g of negative 2. We use the function y equals 1. There is no place to plug the x. That is our answer. It will always be 1. It's a constant function. Finally, we do g of 5. And again, when x is 5, it's not equal to negative 2, so we're back up here for the third one. So we're going to go g of 5 equals 1 fourth x plus 1. So we put in the 5. And so 5 times 1 fourth, multiplying the numerator, we get 5 fourths plus 1. I'm going to write 1 as a fraction of divided by 4, so 4 over 4. One's another way to write that is 4 over 4, get the common denominator. 5 plus 4 is 9. 9 fourths. So that is our answer here, 9 fourths. And again, we would use this fraction key. Fraction template to put that one in there. And that's the answer and how we do question number 2.